Dedicate yourself and you gon' find yourself
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Earliest things I can think of is him cutting down a putter for me when I was about 3 years old and being out in the green at Jackson Country Club, where he was initially for 30 years. And I remember my mom and dad both having me out there a bunch, but being out there for junior golf on Fridays in the summer, just a lot of memories. I'm thankful that through golf, we had a bond because of him working, you know, so many hours at the golf course in the summer. It really was able to bring us together, which was something cool was even as a young child. So yeah, I think the biggest quality is he's a Christian man. And so the fact that his faith really guides what he does on a day in day out basis and something he imparted in me, I'm very thankful for that. I think that's first and foremost, no question. One, I think it's just so deserving because of the time and effort, you know, he's given his life to this profession. And I think that, that it's something he's so deserving of. And with that said, you know, I've looked and seen who other members in the Section Hall of Fame, and I mean, it's a pretty elite group of people. And I think it's really cool for him to have that opportunity to join that group, and just well-deserving. Everything, you know, looking back over his career, you know, 45 plus years, he's been the consummate golf pro as far as what he does on a day in, day out basis. It's so deserving. I'm just so proud of him for that. Dad, I love you so much. I'm proud of you. The career that you've had is just been amazing, and this is such a deserving honor. And I'm so happy for you that you're being honored tonight. And I just want to congratulate you.
Well, he likes to coach golf with me. Congratulations, Grandpa, and I'll hope him.
He's been a great husband to me. We've been married almost 37 years. And he's been extremely dedicated to his work. And especially, I think, when you think in terms of promoting golf, because he's done a lot of promoting in terms of helping with the junior programs over at Jackson Country Club and at Cocopelli. And he's just an all-around good guy. I'm very proud of him. Back in the mid-90s, he got involved with wanting to work with the rules. And I'm just very proud of him for all the places that's taken him and me. We've got to do a lot of traveling together and got to meet a lot of really nice people. And that's been something that I've really been proud of him for. He is someone that is there and available when he's needed, but he doesn't try to be showy with it. He is just an all-around professional rules official, and I think he's respected that way with the other guys on the committee. They see him that way, and he's very knowledgeable. He finally got 100 on the rules exam, and that's quite a feat. So I'm proud of him for that, too. For me, it just shows that Jesse is well-respected in the golf world, and that I'm very proud of him for achieving all the things that he's achieved in his career. I was a school teacher, and I retired 10 years ago, and he's just until this year worked and worked hard at his job. And so I'm proud that he's finally getting a lot of recognition from the Gateway Section for all the things that he's accomplished with his golf. Jesse, I just want to say I'm very proud of you. I'm very proud of the Christian man you are. I'm very proud of all the work you've done locally and nationally with your golf career. And just congratulations. I love you very much.
Jesse and I go back 40 years, 1976, I think. Jesse became the head professional at Jackson Country Club, and I worked in the pro shop cleaning clubs and shagging balls, and I started working for him then and worked for him for 9, 10 years after that. went through the ranks, became an assistant with him, and just have known him ever since. Been a good friend ever since, and a teacher. Yeah, and he got into the rules part of it. I think he found his niche. I think he found something that he really, really enjoyed to do outside the shop. And I mean, I can remember, and this was early on when I worked for him, is that he would study that stuff. The rest of us golfers and golf professionals really don't care too much about it, I don't think, but he really got into that, which was really a neat thing, because a lot of people just don't think of it. You know, they just don't look at the rules official out there at a tour event, or the rules official at any golf tournament for that matter. So, and I think he found his niche and something that he really enjoyed doing, and of course everybody knows we're really good at it. From there, I ultimately became his banker. You know, I got in the banking business, and he and I have had a relationship, both business and professional and friendship-wise, for 40-plus years. And the people that know Jesse and know the things that he's gotten involved with, that see him on TV, at, you know, one year he did the Masters, seen him at the Ryder Cup.
The referee for this match is from Cocopelli Golf Club in Marion, Illinois, Jesse Barge. On the tee, representing
all those different things, they're like, hey, this is the guy we go to church with. Is this the guy that, you know, we've seen at the pro shop for 30 years and stuff? We see him at the coffee shop or whatever in the morning. So it's kind of neat. There's some really, I was telling some friends at work, there's some really neat pictures of Jesse from the Ryder Cup, Olympia Fields, I think it was Chicago, when he was calling Rory McIlroy. He was the walking official with Rory McIlroy and almost had to disqualify him for being late for his tee time. But there was a great picture in Sports Illustrated when that match ended, that Jesse's on the green with McIlroy, and I forget who he was playing that day. And there's, the, you know, the I think everybody's probably seen the video with him and Zach Johnson at, I think it was Chambers Bay. They got into a little bit of a tat for tat on the on a lie in the bunker and stuff. So,
if it's not a stone,
it's not a stone. Right?
Okay. Okay.
So if it's just club sand.
So it's not player or group discretionary.
No.
Even if you're here.
Even if I'm here.
That's harsh. All right.
Okay.
Thanks for nothing. No, I'm just kidding.
It's, yeah, it's kind of neat to see that stuff. And I think people that really know Jesse and understand his part of the golf business really think that's a great thing. Hey, Jess, just want to say congrats on your induction into the Gateway PGA Hall of Fame. Definitely a much deserved honor. Your 40 plus years in the golf business is a lot more than a lot of guys I know could do. And your devotion to your craft and to your members and to your family are beyond reproach. So congratulations from Sandy and I. Hope you enjoy a little bit of retirement, still get a little bit of that rules things done. And hopefully one of these days you and I can start playing golf again. Thanks and congratulations.
We met when we took over this facility here. And Jesse was the professional at the time, and he has really been a godsend to me. With him working that he has out on the tour, different events, he's had to make rulings that may cost somebody an extraordinary amount of money. And so to be able to do that and keep that composure, it's an amazing thing. He has brought stability to Cocopelli. He has been able to, in a tough business in Southern Illinois, keep things to the level and par that they should be, and handle things with that composure that I've talked about, and just do a great job representing Cocopelli and being the face of the golf.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you're having a wonderful evening. Jesse Barge, 39-year PGA member, 20-year member of the PGA of America Rules Committee. I'd like to congratulate you on all you've done for the game, for the PGA of America, but more importantly, for your representing us so well on the PGA of America Rules Committee. You've officiated at all our major championships. You do it in a first-class professional manner and are a great ambassador for the game. I'd like to wish everyone all the best for this evening. And congratulations, Jesse, on your induction into the Hall of Fame.